You're good looking and single. Doesn't your family not ask you to get married?
I'm working on that.
21 world titles. I know it's an incredible achievement. But if asked to pick one of your sweetest victories, which one would that be and why?
I feel like my first world title has been the most special one in my career because I went there as a nobody. I went to China to play the World Snooker Championships, representing India for the first time in snooker. And it was an incredible journey where I was almost knocked out of the tournament. And one fluke changed the entire course of the event for me. And I ended up winning the World Championship just at the age of 18, beating a Pakistani player in the final. So that really would be my most memorable moment till date in my sporting career.
What is Pankaj Advani like when he puts his cue down? There are different facets of your life that if you can share.
Well, if it helps, you know, I'd like to tell the kids that I don't drink at all.
Wow.
I'm actually a teetotaler because I only have tea. That's my favorite beverage, whether it's in the morning or evening. Of course, it's not that I'm trying to advise you or tell you that it's bad for you. It's everybody has their own choice and way of looking at things, but alcohol is something that really clouds your judgment and it changes the way you think as an individual. And anything that, any substance you consume which alters your thinking is definitely not good for your health because it makes you defy logic and you become irrational after consuming these things. You know, besides that, when I'm not playing in tournaments or preparing for my matches, I like watching superhero films. And I'm sure all you guys have your favorite superheroes. I'm a huge Batman fan. I watched all Batman films, so it's something that I like doing. Just watching any superhero film for that matter, whether it's a DC character or a Marvel character, it just fascinates me. Although, you know, a lot of them may think that I'm, you know, thinking like a kid, but it's just good to see, you know, a different side of things. And because entertainment actually takes you to another world. And, you know, when you live, you do your daily activities and your daily things, you want something to just take you to another world. So superhero films does that for me.
And how about your lifestyle? Like, how do you spend your time? Is it reading? Is it watching movies or music?
Yeah, I love music. I love spending time with family and friends because whenever I'm traveling, I'm away from my closest near India ones for a long period of time. But I like doing different things as well. Like recently, we've started academies in different schools in Bangalore. And I would like to actually introduce this sport in different, in across schools in India where kids can have access to facilities of
Billiards and Snooker. Access is one of the biggest issue, I guess, people face in Q sports.
Absolutely,
I mean,
absolutely.
You started with game parlors.
Yeah. So to give them formal training, get them to actually learn from a good coach, provide them with the opportunity to play this game and be coached by an expert, then take them, you know, do a little bit of talent scouting, take them to inter-school tournaments. We all have plans, you know, we have plans to do all of these things in the future, but they will take time to shape up.
Correct.
We have to target the youth. And that's why it's so important to keep them, you know, healthy and fit and encourage them to take up different kinds of sports.
Pankaj, we have some of your, you know, diehard fans who also play snooker and billiards. They have some questions for you.
You're good looking and single. Doesn't your family not ask you to get married?
I'm working on that. No, actually, truly am. Yeah, there have been a few proposals and, you know, I have met a few girls, to be honest. Yeah, thanks for those compliments, by the way. Not everybody thinks the same. Yeah, you'll hear the good news soon, hopefully. I mean, I'm keeping my fingers crossed. I do believe there's a time and place for everything. And I don't think I was ready for marriage a couple of years ago. But, you know, I think guys mature a little late. You girls mature so fast that it's difficult for us to keep up. But yeah, in the next 1.5 years, I am looking to go ahead and settle down because I do believe that, you know, every phase of life you need to do certain things at a particular time, otherwise time runs out.
Hi, I'm Zainab Saria. Being a celebrity and a known face, I'm pretty sure there must be like trolling on social media. How do you deal with the negativity both online and offline?
It's part and parcel of every person who's in the public eye. It's not easy, let me tell you. We're all human beings at the end of the day. Everybody has feelings. If people think that those who are famous are in a world of their own, let me tell you, it's not the case. We're all human beings. We all want peace, happiness. We all want appreciation at the end of the day, but we know that we're not always going to get it. And that's the price we pay. And criticism is okay, as long as it's constructive. But the moment it becomes destructive criticism, that's when you take offense. So there are times I've reacted to trolls also, and I'm not very proud of it because I feel like if they're saying something, why should I stoop down to that level? And if there is some truth in it, then I quietly endure it. So it's also about being aware of where you think you could have gone wrong. But at the same time, if people are being unreasonable with you, then, you know, I think it's best not to react, because that's where you actually truly show your maturity.
Why do QAs always dressed in a formal attire, and why not in a sporting attire?
For a long time, I've actually been against the dress code of the waistcoat and bow tie and you know, long sleeve shirt and trousers, because I feel it's actually restrictive. And as a player, because when you're playing, you're restricted, because you're, you know, the bow tie is sort of kind of strangling you in a way. The shirt is there, the waistcoat is there, and it kind of restricts you and your movement when you're playing. At the same time, I feel like if we play in shorts and in extremely casual attire, it will just not blend with the image of the sport. I'm not saying that this sport is meant only for the elite or rich people. I mean, all of us who've performed in this sport have come from middle class backgrounds, and you know, I feel that it's not really expensive to take up a sport like billiards and snooker. You know, because it's played in an indoor environment, it's not extremely physical in nature in terms of running or using physical power. I do feel that, you know, even a waistcoat with a long sleeve shirt and jeans, or maybe even trousers, but not the bow tie. I feel like the bow tie could definitely be eliminated from the dress code. And I've been vocal, in fact, yeah, about this for a few years, but I don't know why the international bodies still choose to stick to it. But I'm not a great fan of the extremely formal dress code. I feel that it could be toned down a bit.
21 world title itself is incredible achievement, but what is your ultimate dream? That, okay, 50 titles, 60 titles?
Over the years, whenever I've played, initially I thought if I win one world title, it'll be great. And I must relate this small incident where a journalist asked me when I was just 11 years old, after I won my first tournament, what would you like to become when you grow up? And very innocently, I said, I would like to be a world champion. And I didn't even know how much time it would take or whether I was good enough or not, because at the age of 10-11, you're just starting off the game, you really don't know how good you are in the game, and you're yet to fulfill your potential. The fact that I thought about it itself meant that it was there in my mind, and that I had that belief that I would do it. Again, I'm just reiterating, you know, the fact that it's so important to dream big, and only when you dream big, you know, will you eventually work towards reaching there, and you know, you'll do the right things and put in all that you have.
Thank you, Pankaj, for being on our show.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.